students, welcome back to English online class. Today we are going to discuss The Portrait of a Lady by Khushwant Singh. First, let's discuss about the author. Khushwant Singh was an Indian writer. He was born on 2nd February 1915. His famous novelist Trained to Pakistan. He got many awards like Padma Bhushan and Padma Vibhushan. And finally, he was dead on 20th March 2014. Now let's discuss the prose, The Portrait of a Lady. The Portrait of a Lady is the story of the author and the grandmother. He describes his relationship with her over the years. He pens down her daily activities and how she evolved as a character as time passed by. Now, let's divide the lesson into 5 subheadings. First, introduction of the lesson. Second, life in the village. Third, life in the city. Fourth, author's higher studies. And finally, grandmother's death. In the introduction, the author described about the character of the grandmother. He also mentioned about the grandfather who had passed away a long before. Now let's discuss the character of the grandmother. The grandmother was a fat, short lady, but she was very religious. As she was very old, her face was filled with wrinkles and she used to walk slightly bent. She had silver white hair, but she was a very pure soul, a calm and lovable lady. I hope now you got an idea about the grandmother. Now let's read the lesson and know in detail. My grandmother, like everybody's grandmother, was an old woman. She had been old and wrinkled for the 20 years that I had known her. So, the author said that the grandmother was very old and he remembered that right from the 20 years of time that he watched the grandmother with the same old way with full of wrinkles on her face. People said that she had once been young and pretty and had even had a husband, but that was hard to believe. Here, the author says that the people around him said once that the grandmother was very young and beautiful and even she had a husband. But the author couldn't believe that. Do you know why? Because as far as his memory, when he saw the grandmother, she was looking very old as well as no husband was there for her. So it was very hard for him to believe that. My grandfather's portrait hung above the mantelpiece in the drawing room. He wore a big turban and loose-fitting clothes. His long white beard covered the best part of his chest and he looked at least 100 years old. In the drawing room, the grandfather's portrait was hung above the mantelpiece. A mantelpiece is a structure of wood, marble or stone above and around a fireplace. You can see here in the picture. And the grandfather wore a big turban and loose-fitting clothes. He had a long white beard that covered his chest. And he was looking so old, like 100 years old man. As for my grandmother, being young and pretty, the thought was almost revolting. She often told us of the games she used to play as a child that seemed quite absurd and undignified on her part, and we treated it like the fables of the prophets she used to tell us. It was almost revolting. It means very hard to believe. Which thought was almost revolting? That people told the author the grandmother was once young and pretty. But it was very hard for the author to believe that. He felt it as quite absurd. Absurd means illogical. And he treated those things like the stories told by the prophets. She had always been short and fat and slightly bent. Her face was a crisscross of wrinkles running from everywhere to everywhere. No, we were certain she had always been, as we had known her, so terribly old that she could not have grown older and had stayed at the same age for 20 years. Here, the author says that she was short, fat, and because of her old age, she was slightly bent. Her face was fully covered with wrinkles from everywhere to everywhere. It means it was fully covered with wrinkles. And also, for the past 20 years, the author saw the grandmother this much older. She could never have been pretty, but she was always beautiful. She hobbled about the house in spotless white, with one hand resting on her waist to balance her stoop, and the other hand telling the beads of her rosary. Her silver locks were scattered untidily over her pale, puckered face, and her lips constantly moved in inaudible prayer. Yes, she was beautiful. She was like the winter landscape in the mountains, an expanse of pure white serenity, breathing peace and contentment. Here, the author said that the grandmother could never be pretty, but she was beautiful. What is the difference here, pretty and beautiful? Here, the author mentions that it is not the outer beauty, that is the materialistic beauty, but she was beautiful by heart. And also, she hobbles around the house in spotless white. That is, she always wear beautiful, white, clean clothes. Hobble means to walk in an awkward manner. Due to her old age, she walks slightly bent, which looks like in an awkward manner. And always she carries a bead of her rosary, the beads which she used to chant her prayer. This point signifies that she is very religious. She was like the winter landscape in the mountains, an expanse of pure white serenity, breathing peace and contentment. It means that the grandmother was very calm, peaceful character. Hope you have understood these points that we have discussed today. If you have any doubts, let's clear it.